Here at DNews, we love space and we love cats, so it's about time that we talk about cats in space. Sorta. Hey all you Earthbound suckers, Trace here for DNews. Today, we're gonna do something a little different. While poking around on the internet, we found this science video. We could just not figure it out.
In these experiments, you can see the disorientation resulting when an animal is suddenly placed in a weightless state.
After watching that, we had to find out where did this footage come from and what is going on with those weightless cats. Well, it turns out the answer stretches back to before NASA even existed, and those cats are still affecting our space program today. The space race began in 1957 with the Soviet launch of Sputnik 1, the very first man-made satellite. That's the actual sound of Sputnik 1 while orbiting the Earth, by the way. Sputnik lit a fire under the United States to get to space, and within 9 months, NASA was up and running. But it turns out NASA wasn't the only game in town when it came to space research. The American military had been studying the effects of extreme flight on pilots since World War I, and they knew that if we were going to beat the Russians to space, we would need to understand how the human body responded to changes in gravity, like the huge G-forces of a rocket launch or the microgravity environment of orbit. And how did we study new and dangerous things in the 50s? With animals. Here's a rocket test from 1952, 5 years before NASA was founded. On board were two Philippine monkeys and two white mice. These animals became some of the very first to survive a rocket flight, and that gave us some of our earliest data on both extreme G-forces and microgravity. Brave, brave rocket monkeys. But anyway, in 1958, NASA comes online with the immediate goal of getting an American into orbit. But they don't have the facilities or the scale to conduct all the experiments they want to conduct. So in 1961, in steps an Air Force department called the Aerospace Medical Division, or AMD. They work with NASA on experiments designed to get the Project Mercury spaceflight program up to snuff, and there's some pretty intense tests. Here's the AMD trying out an ejection seat for a fighter jet.
The main parachute starts to deploy, but in this particular test, it collapsed partially. The subject received an opening shock estimated at 16.5 G, and lost consciousness.
The AMD ran most of their tests on humans, but you guessed it, they are also responsible for this video. In order to study weightless animals without actually sending them into orbit, AMD loaded cats, and also pigeons, onto a cargo plane. Then they sent it into a controlled free fall. Voila, 0 Gs. And 60 years later, double voila, internet gold. But what on earth can kicking cats around a cargo plane teach us about humans in space? Well, a lot, actually. In 1961, the AMD published a paper that described techniques to help people rotate themselves while floating in zero gravity. Experiments like these taught us the bend and twist, the lasso, and wait for it, the cat reflex, which looks a lot like this. The point is, basic things like how to move your own body are not intuitive in space. But by copying nature, scientists taught our astronauts how to survive in orbit and beyond. So thanks to a lot of hard work by NASA and the Air Force, we now have footage of floating scientists juggling cats. Your tax dollars at work. The pigeons, though, still have no idea what that's about. So, what do you guys think? Is this worth our tax dollars? Let us know down in the comments. Subscribe for more DNews, and let us know if you liked this new format of video. We're gonna try this a few more times. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.